In the U.S., 1 in 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer in her lifetime. But now trials are underway for a vaccine that could actually prevent aggressive forms of breast cancer. And joining me now via Zoom to fill us in on this is breast cancer surgeon and author of the book, Breasts, the Owner's Manual, Dr. Kristi Funk. Welcome back to the show. Always great to see you, Kristi.
And great to see you.
This is exciting stuff. So tell us about the vaccine.
Okay, so this is a vaccine for triple negative breast cancer. It's still just a phase one trial, which means it's being tested on a small group of women just to prove that it's safe and actually does what it's supposed to do. However, even though we have to wait a few years for it to be widely distributed, it is so exciting because all the vaccines we've been looking at with breast cancer are always aimed on the back end after a diagnosis to help prevent recurrence. This vaccine is developed with true prevention in mind. You get the vaccine and you never develop a triple negative breast cancer.
Wow, this is pretty exciting stuff. Tell us more, Kristi, about how the trial is actually being conducted.
So it's quite small. They're looking for 18 to 25 women who've had early stage triple negative breast cancer with all treatments completed in the last 3 years. Each woman will get one vaccination spaced 2 weeks apart for a total of 3 vaccinations.
Gotcha. And you use this term of art, triple negative breast cancer. Explain to us why that's significant.
So whenever you have a breast cancer, we look for the presence of 3 receptors on that cancer cell surface. Receptors for estrogen, progesterone, and a growth factor called HER2. When you have a receptor, that's good because now we can aim something at it. We can block it, degrade it, stop the fuel for it. But when you don't have any of those 3, no estrogen, progesterone, or HER2, it's termed triple negative. Because there's no target, I mean, what are we going to aim at? This makes triple negative the most aggressive and least curable cancer that we diagnose. It accounts for 15% of all breast cancers.
Tell us, who is most at risk for this type of cancer?
Triple negative affects younger women more often and Black women. Their rate when they get breast cancer, 22% of them will be triple negative versus 11% in whites. And then the hardest hit group is the BRCA1 mutation carrier. So these women have a 70 to 80% chance that the cancer they develop will be triple negative. And also, like I've been implying, even though it's only 15% of all cancers diagnosed, it is disproportionately accounting for much more than 15% of the deaths and recurrence.
Wow. I mean, that is significant. So very exciting. Tell us, how is the vaccine supposed to work?
Okay, so it targets a very specific breast lactation protein called alpha lactalbumin. And it's no longer found in a normal aging breast cell, but this protein is present in the majority of triple negative cancers. So the vaccine prompts your immune system to have a response against the protein, which then allows the immune system to destroy these cancerous cells before they can actually form a threatening tumor.
So targeting your own immune system to help prevent the cancer in the first place. Such cool technology.
It really is. So while we're all sitting around waiting for this vaccine with anticipation, I do want to remind people that there are a number of dietary and lifestyle interventions that have been shown to maximally reduce your chances of ever facing this potentially killer disease. So you want to espouse a whole food plant-based diet, exercise regularly, maintain an ideal body weight, and minimize alcohol. A recent study showed that just 3 drinks a week can increase breast cancer by 15%.
Such important tips. As always, thank you for your expertise. I'm sure we'll see you soon.
Can't wait.